The compound ratio of x is to y, y is to z, z is to p. Children, do this. Type the answer in the chat box.
So what's compound ratio?
Oh, you didn't come for the, I mean, you didn't come in the first 5-10 minutes, right? No problem. Just wait, I'll tell you what it is. Let your friends do, I'll tell you. So children, here, if I have the ratio A is to B, C is to D, and E is to F. Children, if I have three ratios, those have joined late, please observe me this. Observe this. Children, if I have three ratios, A is to B, C is to D, and E is to F. Now the compound ratio of these three will be A into C into E by B into D into F. Okay. A into C into E by B into D into F. So children, here I'll have what? X into, first is X here, and then I have Y here, and I have a Z here. So X into Y into Z divided by Y into Z into P. Now, X, Y and Y gets cancelled. Z and Z gets cancelled. So what is remaining here, children? I have X by P. So this is the answer. The answer is option B. X is to P. Children, are we okay here?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yashika, clear now? How to get the compound ratio?
Yeah, sir, clear.
Yeah. Anjali, oh, Fawaz is not around, okay. Anjali, are you understanding, Anjali, how you're getting this? Children, duplicate ratio. What will be the duplicate ratio? What? What do you mean by what, Yashika? What's happening? We have seen the definitions, right, children? We have seen duplicate ratio, subduplicate ratio, triplicate ratio, subtriplicate ratio. Yes or no?
Sir, I came when you were saying something about multiplicative ratio.
Okay, no problem. Your friends will help us. So children, when I say duplicate, yeah, the answer is option C, children. So when I say duplicate ratio, what it means is, well, suppose I have two numbers A and B. Let me repeat this once again for those who are not around. If I have two numbers A and B, the duplicate ratio for this will be what? A square, E to B square. This is the duplicate ratio. Now I have root 3 here. That means what? I need to get a root 3 square. Now what is the value of root 3 square? No, root 3 square is nothing but root 3 into root 3. Isn't it? So root 3 into root 3, children. Root 3 into root 3 will be 3. Similarly, root 5. Root 5 square will be. Children, please wait. Do not interrupt now. I'll get back to you guys. So root 5 square will be what? Root 5 into root 5. That will be 5. So the ratio will be A square is to B square here, children, is 3 is to 5. The answer is 3 is to 5.
Excuse me, sir. Can I just tell what I understood, like, about...
Neha, I'll give you time. Just wait. Yashika, are we clear, Yashika, no?
Sir, what does root represent? Why do we use this root?
Okay, good question. So if I have a root 4, okay, now 4 can be written as 2 into 2, right? Root 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Now when there's a square root, what will I do is I'll take only a 2 outside. So root of 4 is written as 2. Similarly, if I have a root 9, I can write 9 as 3 into 3. I mean, root will be there here. So root of, so that means what? Since square root is there, only 1 3 will come out. So that means what? Root of 9 is 3. Children, what will be the answer for this? The duplicate ratio of root of A is to B square. So here duplicate ratio means what? I need to take a root of A square and square of b square. So root of a square will be, root of a square will be a, and b square whole square will be b power 4. So the answer in this case will be first option. So when I say b square whole square, that means what? I'm multiplying b square by itself. So b square into b square would be b power 4. So children, the answer in this case will be option A.